Alabama's gotten me so upset. Tennessee made me lose my rest. Everybody knows about Mississippi, goddamn. Can't you see it? I know you can feel it. It's all in the air. I can't stand the pressure much longer. Somebody say a prayer. Alabama's got me so upset, and Governor Wallace has made me lose my rest. Everybody knows about Mississippi, goddamn.
It's been a story of both progress and a little bit of stagnation.
It is an incredibly divided time that we live in.
I think we have a lot more work to do.
We can't go back, we can't revert.
Being involved in the Me Too movement and having had my career derailed by Harvey Weinstein.
When women got up and said, we're just not gonna take it anymore.
The overturning of Roe v. Wade.
And we were watching our coverage as that decision was announced to the country. And I actually started to cry.
Almost half of all of the states in the United States have banned abortion.
The idea of women's rights being taken away, and that is terrifying to me.
My grandchildren now have less rights than I had when I was their age.
My two daughters now have less autonomy and rights over their body than I did.
It was the moment when former President Trump rode the escalators down to announce his candidacy.
The election of an African American to the presidency of the United States.
But seeing Kamala Harris become the first female person of color vice president gave me hope.
We have forgotten that we are mostly the same.
We became capable of being kinder to ourselves.
While women have made incredible strides, men have also come a long way.
Men have become intentional.
And not just making sure that we had a seat at the table, but actually recognizing that we have brains.
The importance of being engaged both civically and in community.
I was leading an organization that was responsible for the distribution of the vaccine.
In the COVID pandemic, you know, it has affected, I think, everything that we now do.
COVID and how it changed our perspective and our priorities.
The role of technology in our lives.
It would be when the iPhone came out. Everything was built at the rise of mobile.
There's extraordinary information and globalization.
I've been able to get the proper messages out through social media and get those messages to spread.
Meteoric rise in social media and the 24-hour news day.
There's an assault on history and on the truth.
We are entering an age of untruth and mistrust.
Attacks on freedom of the press around the world.
What is happening in Afghanistan and the women of Afghanistan?
We continue to see women treated as second, third, fourth, fifth class citizens. And it's not abroad, it's not just in other countries.
So much around racial injustice, as well as guns totally going out of control.
When we are scared to send our kids to school, or we wonder if they can walk down the street wearing a hoodie, or go to a movie, or go to church, that doesn't feel like freedom.
We need to make the 21st century the feminine century.
I think the change has to be an internal revolution for women.
If women had our full rights of self-determination, can we imagine the power that would be unleashed?
Get back in touch with humanity and why we're all here.
Because I'd really like to see women being themselves.
More women to express themselves in the arts.
I would like to have my daughter be able to create and manifest so much more.
The daughters of all my friends, my granddaughter, will never have to answer a question that starts with, as a woman, how do you feel?
We have to redefine the definition of leadership and what it is to be ambitious.
If she has passion and talents and interests and ambition, that she can follow those into any field, regardless of what zip code she was born in.
Role models for younger women to look up to and say, I too can do that.
More women in the CEO position, as well as running huge lines of business
in public companies.
I want the daughters and the young girls who are watching us right now to look up to us, not as relics, but as people who paved the way.
More and more women who work in lots of jobs, service jobs, other jobs, can break through.
Getting women involved in STEM.
With the right leadership, the education system changing in our country.
I believe AI is going to really transform how we live.
People are grounded in reality, not false messaging, not false images.
Better collaboration with all technology leaders on what the true impact's gonna be, not just on the environment, but for our society as a whole.
Every job is a climate job, because every business decision that you make has climate impacts.
Women need to continue to advocate for one another, support one another.
We need to build an entire table for women, and we all need to look and think differently.
The next 20 years, we're in really good hands with this young generation of very powerful young women that are not allowing anything to hold them back.
Put your blinders on, go full speed ahead, just keep on trucking.
So women, support each other, and the next 20 years are gonna go like this.
So I'm here because of you.
Oh, the one I wrote?
Uh-huh.
I forgot it, yes.
Under Supernode Ventures Cap.
And I'm here as part of the Move's Power Women coffee table book.
Do you know this was my friend's apartment? Isn't that weird?
This?
Yeah, he rented it.
I'm here today with New York, is what's called New York Magazine.
Can you even read that?
Got a long one. There.
I don't know if that looks like a martini or not, but we'll make it.
Heidi Waldorf, MD. Ouch. Oh. Oh. Sorry, do it again.
Ready?
All right, take two. Yes.
Still look at the camera, not
yes.
You. Okay.
Over the last 20 years, one of the most, where should I be looking? At the mic or at the camera?
And I, what was the other thing?
Cup.
I'm down in Brazil. I'm an author.
I'm not a studio, you know.
And don't show that on any rewind of anything like that.